everyone. I wanted to do a video as I'm editing my Disney vlog. As many of you may know, I went to Florida. I went to Universal and Disney. My Universal vlog is up. Went to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, and I'm editing my Disney one, so that should be up next week in a week or two. And I kind of wanted to shed some light on some hardships that the eating disorder caused on vacation. I do want to give a disclaimer. If any of you are struggling with an eating disorder, just be aware of anything that may come up that could be triggering, and if you need to close out of the video, please feel free. I love you, don't want you to be triggered and get even have any issues because of my video. So please, just wanted to give that little warning. There were a few issues and hiccups the first few days. This was my first vacation in a couple of years, and my first vacation being back from treatment in Florida for my eating disorder. And I wanted to start by saying that it was hard. Going on vacation, there's restaurants, there's, you know, especially when you go to a theme park, there's a lot of food that the society deems as unhealthy, you know, funnel cakes, corn dogs, big buckets of buttered popcorn, you know, seen as unhealthy in society, like labeled, deemed essentially like bad. So I felt uncomfortable with that aspect because I let the eating disorder kind of talk into me, like, you know, you can't get those things, like, you can't spend, and one, they're a lot of money. So my brain eating disorder got to me, like, first off, you don't need that. That's way too gross, unhealthy. That's gonna make you gain a ton of weight. You don't need it. And the money is not worth it. I mean, like, you could save that money for something better. And that was harping at me a lot of the trip, especially with just, like, the new year had started and people are, you know, talking about after the holidays losing weight and all this. And so it was kind of a little hard because we went, you know, a couple weeks ago at the end of January into the beginning of February. And I also just, it was hard to be able to eat what I want when I want. Like second full day, we went, my sister and I went to Universal. My parents were coming to pick us up after spending our first day at Harry Potter World, and they wanted to go out to eat as a family because my dad was leaving the next day and we hadn't really done anything with them. And so they wanted to go out to eat, but my eating disorder of course told me, you ate at the theme park all day. You don't need to go out to some sit-down restaurant and have some big meal. Mm-mm. So what did I let my eating disorder do? I let my eating disorder throw a big hissy fit and end up sitting at the restaurant like a two-year-old pouting because the anxiety just built up so much, like, I can't eat that big plate of pasta. I can't have that breadstick. I ate this and this and this today. It was so overwhelming. I wanted to cry at the table. I ended up crying in bed later that night when we got back. But that was also fun. And then 3 days later, no, 2 days later, we had gotten back. My sister and I spent the day at Hollywood Studios, and my mom spent the day at the resort, and we were trying to figure out what to do for dinner, and there was a restaurant in the resort hotel that we were staying at, and we went down, and it was like a bougie one that had like no vegetarian option at all. Thank you very much. I think for an overpriced place, you would have at least one decent vegetarian option. So there was pizza. And the only vegetarian pizza besides cheese was margarita. And my sister doesn't like margarita pizza. So we were thinking about doing cheese. And it just got so overwhelming trying to, because I know, like, I felt bad. Like, I felt so, like, the restaurant was so uncomfortable. Like, it was so, I felt looked down on. Like, if you watch Downton Abbey, I felt like a servant who has sat down at dinner with the higher-ups. Like, I felt so out of place and so judged by the staff. It was uncomfortable. And then the pressure of trying to figure out what to eat after a very long day at a theme park and being the one, like, they were putting, like, I love my parent, my sister, my mom, but they are like trying to do anything to compromise for me and trying to, and in essence of doing that and being sweet and trying to do that, they put all this pressure on me to make the decision. I couldn't do it. I ended up leaving and crying in the hotel room and falling asleep at 7 o'clock at night. And then that hit me. Like, it, I woke up the next day and I had realized I had reached my low point and could not do it anymore. And I just tried my best to let go and enjoy the next day, where we got some Oreo Mickey Mouse funnel cake and we got some Mickey Mouse pretzels. And we had, you know, I mean, like on the last day, after spending all day at the Harry Potter Wizarding World and eating a bunch of food, I'm like, you know what? I'm hungry. It's dinner time. Can we order pizza and eat in the room? And we played charades while eating lovely, yummy, greasy hotel pizza. Because that's what I wanted. And I just felt, it's just, it's so hard. Because, like, vacation, you're supposed to be enjoying, but your eating disorder just talks to you. Like, especially if you go out to eat and you see the calories on the menu or on the boards, if you're at a theme park, like, it's just so overwhelming. And then, like, you can hear chatter all around you, like, oh my gosh, this is so good, but so bad for me. You know, like, it's just trying to really just listen to your body and your brain and the lot, like, not your eating disorder part of your brain, but, like, you get the authentic part of you that says, you know what? Screw it. It's only going on 11 in the morning, but I want some ice cream and that looks good. So I'm going to get me a bowl of ice cream from this ice cream stand. Like, that's okay. Or I want a second butterbeer today. I'm going to have a second butterbeer. You know, like, it's okay. And, like, that was one thing that was really hard. And I don't think people realize, like, vacations are supposed to be fun. They can also be so, so mind strenuous when you have an eating disorder. And I don't think that's something people realize. Because it's all mental and people can't obviously see, like, when you're staring at a menu, the mental stress and pain you're having. I mean, unless, like me, you start crying. But. And I think that's one thing, like, that is very important for people to be aware of is, like, going on vacation when you have an eating disorder sometimes cannot be a full vacation. Like, it takes effort and energy and work. And I think one thing I realized is I need to be able to there's a certain aspect of letting go of, you know what, I don't care if I gain weight, I don't care if people judge me, I don't care. Like, if I want to have more funnel cake because I want more funnel cake, but I already had a decent amount, or what my eating disorder contains a decent amount, I'm going to, and that's okay. Like, I'm still alive and people still love me, and I went on vacation and, you know, ate a bunch of unhealthy food. Like, I got this. And I think that's one thing that the vacation really taught me is my eating disorder, even with treatment, still has that grip. And it's learning to let that final grip truly go now that I'm home. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Love you all.